as I cried alone. Boys, I'm surprised how well you cut my feelings to the bone. Don't wanna leave you, really. I've missed too much time to give you up that easy. To the doubts that complicate your mind.
I strike quickly, being moved.
But thou art not quickly moved to strike.
A dog of the house of the Montagues moves me.
To move is to stir. To be valiant is to stand. So if thou art moved, thou runst away.
Now show myself a tyrant. When I follow the men, I will be cruel with the maids and cut off their heads.
The heads of the maids?
Aye, the heads of the maids.
Yeah. Draw thy tool. Here comes through the house of Montagues.
Quarrel, I will back thee.
But turn thy back and run?
Let us take the law of our sides. Let them begin.
I will frown as I pass by. Let them take it as they list.
Nay, as they dare, I will bite my thumb at them, which is a disgrace to them, if they bear it.
Do you bite your thumb at us?
I do bite my thumb, sir.
Do you bite your thumb at us, sir?
Is the law on our side if I say I?
No.
No.
No. No, sir, do not bite my thumb at you, sir, but I bite my thumb,
sir.
Do you quarrel, sir?
Quarrel, sir? No, sir.
If you do, sir, I am for you. I serve as good a man as you.
No better, sir.
Say better, here comes my master's kinsman.
Yes, better, sir.
You lie!
Gregory, remember that swashing blow.
Ooh!
Wait.
Ooh!
Get him!
Park, fools! Put up your sword! You know not what you do.
What art thou drawn among these heartless knights? Turn thee, Benvolio, look to you. Look upon thy death.
I do, but keep the peace with thy sword, or a man in these men depart with me.
What drawn in talk of peace? I hate the word as I hate hell, all Montagues, and thee. Have at thee, coward!
What noise is this? Give me my longsword, huh? My sword, I say, old Montague has come.
Rebellious subjects, enemies to peace, defenders of this neighbor, stain steel. Will they not hear? What? Ho, you men, you beasts, throw your mysterious weapons to the ground, and hear the sentence of your moved prince. Three silver bras, read of an airy word, by thee, old Capulet and Montague, have thrice disturbed the quiet of our streets. If ever you disturb our streets again, your life shall pay the forfeit with the peace. For this time, all the rest depart away. You, Capulet, shall go along with me and you, Montague, come you this afternoon to know our further pleasure in this case. Once more, on pain of death, all men depart.
Many times I tried to tell you, many times I cried alone. Always I'm surprised how well you cut my feelings to the bone. Don't wanna leave you really, I've been missed.
Let's just hope that there ain't gonna be a fight.
Yeah, hopefully these masks are
different. Now to complicate your mind, we belong to the light. To the birds, we belong to the sound of the words before falling unheard.
Welcome, gentlemen. I have seen the day that I have worn a visor and can tell a whispering tale and a fair lady's ear. Such as would please, tis gone, tis gone, tis gone. All are welcome. Come, musicians play, a ha ha. Give room and foot it, girls!
I know not, sir.
Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. Did my heart love till now forswear its sight, for I ne'er saw true beauty till this night.
Tybalt, this wise voice should be Montague.
Fetch me my rapier, boy. What dares a slave come hither covered with an antic fate, to fleer and scorn our solemnity? By the stock and honor of my kin, to strike him dead I hold it not a sin.
I have now, kinsmen, wherefore storm you so?
Uncle, this is a Montague, our foe.
Young Romeo, is it?
Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Contempt thee, gentle cause, let him alone. I would not for the wealth of this town, here in my house, do him disparagement.
It fits when such a villain is a guest, I'll not endure him.
He shall be endured.
Why, uncle, 'tis a shame.
Go to, you are a saucy boy, you are a princox. But cheerly, my heart.
Patience, perforce, with willful colder meeting, makes my flesh tremble in their different greeting. I will withdraw, but this intrusion shall now see me.
If I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine, the gentle find is this. My lips, two blushing pilgrims, ready stand to smooth that rough touch with a gentle kiss.
Aye, good pilgrim, you do wrong your hands too much, which merely devotion shows in this. For saints to have hands that pilgrim hands did touch, and palm to palm is holy palmer's kiss.
Have not saint lips and holy palmers too?
Aye, good pilgrim, lips say my season right here.
Then let lips do what hands do, they pray, grant thou, lest faith turn to despair.
Saints do not move, though grant for prayer's sake.
Then move not, while my prayer's effect I take.
Madam, your father craves a word with you. What's he that follows there that would not dance?
He is Romeo on Montague.
My only love spoke for my only hate. Too early seen unknown and known too late.
Away be gone, this word is at best.
I so fear the more is my unrest.
I thank you, honest gentlemen. Good night, all to my rest.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wherefore art thou Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or, if thou wilt not, be but sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet. 'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Yet what is a Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, or face, nor any other part belonging to a man. What's in a name? A rose by any other name would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, still retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name. And for that name, which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word. Call me beloved, and I'll be new baptized.
What man art thou that thus be screened in shade, and so stumblest upon my counsel?
By a name I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself, because it is the enemy to thee. Had I it written, I would tear the word.
My ears have not yet drunk 100 words, or of that tongue's utterance, yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
Tell me how camest thou hither, and wherefore?
The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death.
Considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
With love's light wings that I overperch these walls, for stony limits cannot keep love out. And but thou love me, let them find me here. My life were better ended by their hate than death parode wanting of thy light.
If thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully, or if thou thinkest I am too quickly won, I'll frown and be perverse and say thee nay. But trust me, gentlemen, I prove more true than those who have a cunning to be strange.
Lady, by yonder blessed sun, I swear that tips the gold on all these fruit tree tops.
Swear not by the sun, the sweltering sun.
What shall I swear by?
Do not swear at all, although if you will, swear by thy gracious self, and I will believe thee.
If my heart's dear love.
Do not swear at all, although I take joy in thee. I take no joy in this contract today. It's too rash, too sudden, too unadvised. This bud of summer's ripening breath may prove a beauteous flower when next we meet.
Oh, wilt thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have today?
Thy love's faithful vow for mine.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it, and yet I would it were to give again.
Wouldst thou withdraw it for what purpose, love?
But to be frank and give it thee again, and yet I wish for but the thing I have. My bounty is as boundless as the sea, my love as deep. The more I give it to thee, the more I have. Anon, good nurse. 3 words, dear Romeo, and goodbye indeed. If that the event of love's honorable, thy purposeful marriage, send me word tomorrow.
Madam!
I come anon, good nurse. 1,000 times goodbye.
1,000 times the worst to want thy light. Love goes toward love as schoolboys from their books, but love from love toward school with heavy looks.
Crazy good news.
The day is hot.
Let's retire. For now, these hot days is the mad blood stir.
By my head, here come the Capulets.
By my heel, I care not.
Gentlemen, good then. A word with one of you.
But with one word with one of us. Why not couple it with something? Make it a word and a blow.
Mercutio, thou consorts with Romeo.
Consort? What does thou make us minstrels? And thou make minstrels of us? Look to hear nothing but discords. Here's my fiddlestick. Here's that shall make you dance. Zounds, consort!
We talk here in the public, haunt men. Either withdraw into some private place and reason coldly of your grievances, or else depart, here all eyes gaze on us.
Men's eyes were made to look, and let them gaze. I will budge for no man's pleasure eye.
Well, peace be with you, sir. Here comes my man. Romeo, the love I bear thee can afford no better terms than this. Thou art a villain.
Tybalt, the reason that I have to love thee doth much excuse the appertaining rage. To such a greeting, villain am I none. Therefore, farewell, I see thou knowest me not.
Boy, this shall not excuse the injuries that thou hast done. Therefore, turn in.
Gentle Mercutio, put thy clenched fist down.
Conser, your passado.
Can't stop the bulldozer.
Good for Kishio.
Go.
I am hurt. I am sped. A plague on both your houses. Has he gone and hath nothing?
What? Art thou hurt?
A scratch. Benvolio, help me into some house, or I shall faint. A plague on both your houses.
Romeo, brave Mercutio is dead. This gentleman, the prince's near ally, my very friend, hath got his mortal hurt in my behalf. O sweet Juliet, thy beauty hath made me effeminate. This day's black fate on more days depend. This but begins the woe, others must end.
Here comes the furious Tybalt again.
Come back!
Stop!
Tybalt! Romeo, no! Now, Tybalt, take back the villain that late thou called me, for Mercutio's soul is but a little above our heads. Staying for thine to keep him company, either thou or I or both must go with him.
Thou wretched boy that didst consort him here, shalt with him hence.
This shall determine that.
It's full.
of this fray.
O noble prince, we can discover all, the manage of this fatal brawl. There lies the man slain by young Romeo, that slew thy kinsman brave Mercutio.
He is a kinsman to the Montague. Affection makes him false. He speaks not true.
I beg for justice, which thou, prince, must give. Romeo slew Tybalt, so Romeo shall not live.
Romeo slew him? He slew Mercutio? Who now the price of the dear blood doth owe?
Not Romeo. He was Mercutio's friend. His fall concludes, but with the law should end the life of Tybalt.
And for that offense, immediately we do exile him. Hence, I will be deaf to pleading and excuses. Nor tears nor prayers shall purchase out abuses. Therefore, use none. Let Romeo hence in haste. Else, when he's found, that hour is his last.
Ah, Juliet,
I already know thy grief. I hear thou must, and nothing may prorogue it. On Thursday next, be married to this Paris.
Friar, tell me not that thou hearest it, unless thou tell me how I may prevent it.
Friar, in thy long-lived experience, give me some present counsel, or behold, twixt my extremes and me, this bloody knife shall play the umpire, arbitrating all. I long not to speak, I long to die. If what thou speakest, speak not remedy.
Hold, daughter. I do spy a kind of hope. If rather than to marry County Paris, thou hast the strength of will to slay thyself, then it is likely thou wilt undertake a thing like death to chide away the shame. And if thou darest, I'll give thee remedy.
Oh, bid me leap rather than marry Paris from off the battlements of yonder tower. Shut me nightly in this charnel house, or covered quite with dead men's rattling bones, with reeky shanks and yellow chapless skulls.
Hold then, go home, be merry, give consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Tomorrow night, look that thou lie alone. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and this distilled liquor drink thou off. When presently through all thy veins shall run a cold and drowsy humor, for no pulse shall keep his native's progress, but surcease. Like death when he shuts up the day of life, thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and then awake as from a pleasant sleep. Now when the bridegroom in the morning comes to rouse thee from thy bed, there art thou dead. Thou shalt be born to that same ancient vault, where all the kindred of the Capulets lie. In the meantime, against thou shalt awake, shall Romeo by my letter know our drift, and hither shall he come.
Oh, my love, my wife, death that hath sucked the honey of thy breath hath had no power upon thy beauty. Thou art not conquered. I will stay with thee, and never from this palace of dim night depart again. Here will I set my everlasting rest. Here's to my love. Oh, true apothecary, thy drugs are quick. And thus, with my love, I die.
Where is my lord? I know where I should be, and here I am. Where is my Romeo?
What's this? A cup in my true love's hand. Poison, I see, hath been his time this end.
Oh, churl, drunk all, and left not a friendly drop to help me after. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath.
There, rust, and let me die. Thank you.
that's his murder. Come. Oh, heavens, oh hell.
Seal at the mouth, Malfage, for a while, till we can clear these ambiguities.
Romeo, they're dead, was husband to that Juliet. And she, they're dead, that Romeo's faithful wife. I married them, and their stolen marriage day was to Bolt's doomsday, whose untimely death banished the new bridegroom from this city. For whom, and not for Tybalt, Juliet pined. A sleeping potion I gave Juliet was wrought on her form of death.
Where be these enemies? Capulets, Montagues, see what a scourge is laid upon your hate. That heaven find means to kill your joys with love. All are punished and...
Oh, cousin Montague, give me thy hand. This is my daughter's jointure, for no more can I demand.
But we can give thee more, for we will raise her statue in pure gold. That while Verona by that name is known, there shall no figure at such rate be set as that of true and faithful Juliet.
A glowing peace this morning for with it brings. The sun for sorrow will not show his head, for never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.